Cody, so in today's tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to set an exchange rate server. So, you're taking set x to change it to 0 and forget your event block. So, now it's gonna go to the center. So, if I put it here, see, it goes to the center. So now I go to set, go back to this section, press set y to 100 and put my main goal. See, it goes up. So if I say go to, say, go to x, say, go to x 0 and 0, say, gonna go to the center. So if I put glide 1 second to x 0 y 0, so I'm gonna change this to 100 and this to 100. See, it's gonna glide. So, if I say change x by 10, I'm putting, okay, you went collect. See, it's gonna move like that. So, if I say minus 10, it's gonna go to the back. Say change y by minus 10. See, it goes down. I change this change x to 10. It's gonna go down. Change this to 10. It's gonna go up. So that's that. Now, next thing I'm gonna teach you is how to create your own block. So you go to my blocks and say make block. So this one is for if you wanna add a number or text. Let me say, say okay. When I pull in, like say when pointing to the right, then you can add the level. So let's say create this. This is defines here where I'm pointing to the right. The next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna go to the operators. So this said these things I said I'm gonna teach you later on. So if you take if you notice this is a plus sign. So if you bring it out here and put in 10 plus 10. If you tap on it, it's gonna give you 20. If you tap on it, it's gonna give you 20. So in the later future, I'm gonna use this and I'm gonna create a calculator app using Scratch. So now you can take the minus and let's say 60 minus 20. That is 40. So now, this is times. Let me say 50 times 3. And put events. And put my event clicked. So it's not gonna join because this operates. You need something else. Just tap on it like this, and it's gonna give you your answer. Later on, you're gonna use the flag so that you can make it done properly. So now go back to our operators. So this is times 50 times 3. This is 150. Now for divided by, you do type in 10. You put 2 here. 10 divided by 2 is equals to 5. Give you an answer. Now that's that. So let's go here. Say, so put 10. So 10 is not greater than 50, so it's false. But if I put 100, greater than 15, it's gonna show true. That's that. Now for less than, if I say 10, it's gonna say true because 10 is less than 50. But if I put 1000, it's gonna say false because 1000 is greater than 50. So this later on, we're gonna be using later on to create some other things. So let's go to the variable. So make a variable. Let's say I put in score and press OK. So now let's say set my score to 0 and put event when click. So then in the future, when we're creating a racing game, we are going to need this score. So as you can see, this place up here is the score. Now if I go back to variable and say change my variable by 1, then I'll put something by. So if I change that to 10 and change my this to score, see, whenever I tap, it's gonna change by 10. So it's changed by 10. So that's that. Thanks for watching.